Hey guys, Tough Thumbs here. This will be the second time I'm making this video because I pulled a smoke eater and dropped a knife. But you don't want to show that on camera. Anyway, so I guess you're noticing the white background here. I'm just trying out something different. I noticed that with the usual background, it kind of does something to the colors. And I noticed that it's a little bit more vibrant with the white background. So I'm going to try this out, but then I'm going to make a proper light box pretty soon. I should have done that a long time ago, but anyway, so as you can hear, dubstep in the background, you know, not my favorite music in the world, but I do like it, and I know a lot of you guys do, and a lot of people absolutely just hate it, yeah, I just want to ask quickly, because I don't know, I missed the boat on when this music started, but, you know, I've been listening to it for a while, but if anybody could tell me, like, how you look for this music. I mean, there's, like, no way to find individual albums and, like, artists, and then, like, I hate the, like, R&B, like, singing in it. It's, like, it's, like, the worst singing possible, like, the worst lyrics possible, and then, like, it sounds awesome after, like, 30 seconds of bullshit. I don't know, if there's shit out there that exists, it's just, like, all really heavy, like, in-your-face shit. I like that stuff, guys. So, you know, if you got a suggestion, let me know, because, yeah, I know that's totally off topic, but, you know, I'm just so tired of looking for this shit and just hearing, like, I don't know, just the most terrible singing ever, followed by, like, some awesome shit. So anyway, this is my Deviant Blade. Let's put that out there for the hell of it. So first up, guys, I got 3 pimp jobs. Absolutely fucking mythologically awesome pimp jobs, in my opinion. The first two are kind of like throwbacks to my old shit, and I'm very happy with the results, and it's something I haven't done in a long time. So first up, we got 2 Tenaciouses and a Spyderco Phoenix. So first up, you got your serrated Tenacious Blade. Then you have your classic orange and black G10 Anzo pattern. It's a modified Anzo pattern there. Sometimes when I have the layer G10 and I do grooves in it, I don't really like the way it looks around the edges, so I, you know, do an extra little cut in, which adds a little bit more craziness and depth to it, as you can see, and then also squares off and creates almost like an Aztec. I've explained that in the past, but, you know, I haven't done it in a while, so. But you can see right there, you know, just looks a lot better, a lot cleaner around the edges. Just like perfectly squared. I like that a lot. In here, you see, is not. I do this by hand, and it's kind of rounded, which looks good too, but I just like this, like, perfection here. Unfortunately, this guy came a bit off-center, and the lockup is terrible. I don't know if it's a factory defect or something, but I didn't see anything wrong with it, but I'm going to have to take a look at it. But looking sexy, Spyderco Tenacious, classic, one of the best knives for the money. Man, too bad it's not Duracoat with nothing fancy's name logoed in there. Shit. It'd be worth so much more. Very comfortable, guys. A little bit more beef on there. Classic knife. Love it. So, next up, getting a little bit more technical. Now, this knife I've been keeping, like, wrapped up because I don't want to touch it. I did this a long time ago on a civilian with carbon fiber and white G10. But thank God I'm not using carbon fiber on this one. If there's any dirt on it, too bad. I'm not going to sit here for 6 hours tonight and make sure every little speck is clean, but yeah, this is sick. You got your plain edge, and then it's rocking the white G10 with the black G10 dripping down it. All crazy looking. Kind of got the line pattern on it. Like I said, guys, the only music I got, I lost all my music the other day, so I haven't had a chance to download some of my other music, so I apologize again if you don't like this stuff, but I like it. It's good. Yep. Black and white G10, the shit looks sick as hell. And definitely back then I was using a different epoxy and it made things a lot more difficult, but this with the G-Flex, it's just great. And you know, with this G10, I actually went the extra mile on this one and basically milled down the white to be perfectly flat and thinner before I overlaid it with the black, just because I didn't want it to look super, you know, be too thick, because the black has got to stay up over here, and then it dips down in this area because there's less material. But I think the result, it looks nice from the side here. It's like an ice cream sandwich. Kind of like ink just like pouring down. Feels good. Okay. Alright, for this final, I bet you some crappy ass song's gonna come on. Oh well. Just have to deal with it. Let me see here if I can find something. I don't know any of this shit. Let's see. Nope, that's pretty bad. No, I hate that song. Oh, I hate this song too. Oh, that song sounds horrible. Wow, this song sounds terrible too, holy shit. No, the song... Whatever.
See, you want to talk about the singing?
You guys are probably like, why the hell is he talking about music so much? So anyway, final pimp job of the day, guys. This one, I am so excited about it, and it's like a knife that I've always wanted to really go all out on, but I've never been able to. I did change the scales on it one time, but it was just these little, you know, these little dinky scales at the bottom. They're made out of like white, like plastic or something, but it's not plastic. It's some kind of, I think it's some kind of bone or something. But, you know, the knife, it's all shiny and blah, 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 but... You know, I mean, I don't like shiny shit, and I was given permission to do what I feel was right for this knife, so... Yes, the Spyderco Phoenix is definitely... DKified. So... Got your beautiful, acid stonewashed, which is going to be redone because one spot didn't get it as much. But other than that, just ignore that. But you got... I did not know that the liners in this thing were titanium. So you got your... I'm just going to have to show the whole thing. Yep. So what we got here is the bronze hardware. A dark, like, purple bronze ball in there. Just a regular stonewash gray titanium, and then instead of this shape here, I made it flow a little better, made it look a little bit more manly, I guess. Kind of more like kind of looks like a pistol grip a little bit more. Yeah, I got this little round thing here. It was kind of boring. So you got your thicker titanium and bronze stonewash with the shiny satin screws, which I think looks good. This thing just looks amazing, guys. I'm so happy with this one. And then, it's not over yet. Backspacer, gold fade into the gray. Kind of with like, I'm gonna call this the marbled backspacer, guys. It kind of reminds me of marble or something like that. I just really like the way that looks. I mean, it looks really clean. And you want to do a full scale, but you know, this knife is a little difficult. You see the ball doesn't stick out at all. It's not the easiest knife to disengage. Probably gonna do day shots of this one tomorrow because it's really sweet. Yeah, nice aggressive stonewash, looking beautifully dirty as usual. This thing is just custom as shit now. It looks like some crazy like $1,200 custom knife. It's nice and smooth. Lockup's perfect. Perfectly centered. Just beautiful, guys. Here comes some more shitty music. Hot clip's good. Jesus Christ, music. Alright, silence is golden. We'll just listen to crickets, guys. Yeah, that backspacer brings everything together. It's just, it's really, really intricate looking, but it's just very simple. I gotta get on making my own folder, guys. That backspacer is just beautiful. This may, for me, I think one ups the Manix 2 XL because only for the reason of the how uncommon this knife is and how great it is to see this knife looking actually how it should look and really good. And it feels, with that grip like that, it just feels really, really good, guys. Just really good. Got a little bit of, a little bit more chunk here. It's kind of like you grab it right here. It's just a nice feel. I mean, it's got the little dinky liners here. It's not uncomfortable, but you know, it's definitely not going to create any hot spots. And this choil area is really comfortable in this knife. So yeah, guys, tell me what you think about this one. I personally am absolutely in love with it. This belongs to Pimpy Long Slappins.
God, I don't know if that's the right way to say it. I always forget what his name is because, yeah, Pimpy Long Slappins. And he's also having a knife sale. So you guys definitely subscribe to his channel. Check him out. He's a good dude. I talk to him a lot. And dude, if you're watching, here you go. Here's your Lion Spy with the new acid etch stonewash on it. Looking all greasy. Great, now I can't touch that Tenacious again. Shit. Anyway, alright guys, thanks for watching. Oh, I gotta see this thing closed. It looks beautiful. I think the more scratch this ball gets, the cooler it's gonna look. See, that's why I keep the padding there. Damn, I almost made it. I don't know. I'm in a knife dropping mood today, guys. But there's rubber padding under here, and I didn't hit anything. So, damn it, Smoke Eater. He's cursed, I tell you. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. Have a great night. Peace.